going to make myself some hot chocolate. This is one of my favorite diffusions. The lens is the soul of your story. It creates this beautiful scallop.
You stand over your camera.
Tip number one, always start by lighting the background in your room. And that can be done many different ways. You can use little out of focus lights like this IKEA Boca light. You can use practicals in the background that create this beautiful kind of scallop pattern. You can put some tchotchkes on the top of this cabinet that will create out of focus stuff, highlights and everything when you go in for a close up. The other thing is the classic old slash of light that mixing the tungsten with the daylight, and you can do this with a simple flag. And again, everything is about creating light and shadow. That creates the depth and dimension within your background, and it sets up the ability to, when you go in for the close-up and you're keying from maybe this side, and this side you're going dark, you can then use the highlight in the background to separate the dark side of his face, and it always is classic, but it's absolutely beautiful lighting. Tip number two is lighting the mid-ground. And I'm lighting areas that maybe our actors are gonna be moving in and out of doorways. So I'm putting little accent lights that can kind of highlight things in the background. So I light the mid-ground. Tip number three is room tone. With room tone, I always love to try to bounce something into the ceiling or bounce it off cards that's going to fill and infuse a fill level into the shadows. And I love it to be a medium blue-green color, like cyan. I started doing this on Terminator Salvation, and from that time on, I've done it on every feature film. Now, what I do is I'm popping this with this color, or I'm able to just take a sky panel and throw that color into it, and you can see how it infuses this blue-green nature into your shadows. And I'm kind of, will do this all over the room sporadically wherever I need. Tip number four, with the actors and where they're moving, you wanna light an area, you do not wanna light marks. Because I feel that in this day and age, it's much more freeform. You want the actors to be able to move wherever they want, and it creates a much more emotional impact because the lighting doesn't feel lit. It feels more natural. And then tip number five, when you come in for the close-up, you can see, in my wide shots, I'm probably using egg crates to be able to control the light so it doesn't fly all over the room. And then when I come in for the close-up, I'm ripping this egg crate off so I get all, I am able to see all of the light. So if you come over here, you can see that if I'm looking like this, my face is only seeing like 2/3 of the light. Where if this egg crate was off, I'm seeing the whole source. It's very creamy, very beautiful. And that's your five tips for lighting a room.